Have you heard this before? I need some space. Maybe you've said it to yourself. What if this wasn't about needing some space for a breather, but needing space itself? You know, space. Technology used in space has an essential role in everyday life. Thanks to a satellite, live events are streamed thousands of kilometers away. Farmers forecast weather for crops. Apps deliver food to your door, geopositioning and real-time traffic updates. Financial systems, computer data and mobile phone networks, power grids. That's in addition to aviation, defense and communication systems. Space is everywhere and it's getting busier. NATO understands how important it is to protect our interconnected lives and economies which depend on space technology. Protecting space is no small feat. Some countries already have the means to jam, hack, and even destroy satellites. NATO countries are responding by creating space commands and developing new technologies. And NATO itself has its own space center to support operations and missions, share information, and coordinate allied efforts. NATO has also named space as an operational domain, making it equally important as air, land, sea, and cyberspace. However, NATO has no plans to put weapons in space. Now add in the growth of what was once thought of as science fiction, commercial spaceflight. Space will become even busier as we begin a new era of space tourism. As more people on Earth look to the skies, NATO is addressing critical questions. How will we maintain our peace and safety, even as space becomes busier and more competitive? How are allies working together to ensure responsible behavior in space? So what happens up there really matters, and that's why we're already at work to keep space peaceful and free for everybody. This is just the beginning of a vast ongoing conversation, as everyone realizes we all need some space.